So I do have a Nicki Minaj case update, and it does seem that after Nicki Minaj's lawyer, Judd Bernstein, responded to Tyrone Blackburn, that Jennifer Hough has now obtained a new attorney who goes by Stephen Nicholas Gordon. Now, for you guys who don't know, I did do a full video breaking down Nicki Minaj's response to Jennifer Hough and this lawsuit. Well, after they did get the response from Judd Bernstein, it does seem that Tyrone Blackburn was demoted to second attorney, and she now has a notice of appearance that was filed a couple hours ago by the court saying that Stephen and Gordon is her new representation. Now, Tyrone is still on the case, however, he is the second chair, and I found it quite interesting that this new attorney, Steve Gordon, used to be an associate for Nicki Minaj's lawyer, Judd Bernstein, for only 4 months. So I don't know if he was let go or decided to leave, but to make matters more interesting, he's only been an associate at his current law firm for 2 months. So from his LinkedIn, can see that he doesn't seem to be super experienced when it comes to winning cases. However, he has a lot of education and a lot of background. With that being said, one of the reasons I feel that they went with Stephen and Gordon is because of his association and relationship with Judd Bernstein. When you are an associate, you are legally not a partner of the firm. Although you can be a partner, you're hired by the attorney and you're literally working under the attorney to basically hope that you do get partnership. Now, he was only with Judd Bernstein for 4 months. However, that does not mean that he did not understand and also study Mr. Bernstein and the way that Mr. Bernstein argues the law. My understanding of them hiring him is to understand how Mr. Bernstein is going to move in regards of this lawsuit. Not only would Gordon know some of the things that Mr. Bernstein would argue, but he also has inside knowledge of how that law firm works, and he does have some inside knowledge that could be beneficial for Jennifer's case. With that being said, we also run into conflict of interest. Now, I know a lot of people want to say that this could be conflict of interest, but it's technically not, and it technically is. This is what we call a law ethical dilemma. For example, when you become a lawyer or a licensed professional, you have a duty to the place that you work, you have a duty to the client, and you also have a duty to the profession. Because Mr. Gordon is no longer an associate of Bernstein, technically he can represent Ms. Jennifer Hough. However, he is not able to use privileged information to the benefit of Ms. Hough against Mr. Bernstein. And I do believe that Mr. Bernstein will argue this when they go in the judge's chambers. However, because he's representing her and he used to work there, that is not a conflict of interest. And it would only be a conflict of interest if he was still employed. Now, what's very interesting about this as well is that Steve Gordon's name is still on Mr. Bernstein's website. So I'm wondering what happened here. This new lawyer hasn't really had a job over 1 year and 5 months. I actually went through his LinkedIn and he is a hop around lawyer, allegedly. And I just, you know, I'm hoping that if we are going to get down to the bottom of this, that we are actually going to focus on the law. Do I anticipate this is going to make a difference? Absolutely not. I do think that Nicki Minaj will still prevail. However, it doesn't mean that Jennifer Hough is not going to stop doing interviews. What you guys have to realize is that even if she loses, it is the perception of how people see Nicki, and that is going to be her win, allegedly, right? Because even if she gets no money, people are always going to question Nicki's integrity due to this case, even if Nicki is innocent. So let me know what you guys think about this topic down below. How do you feel about Jennifer Hough basically demoting Tyrone and hiring a former associate of Nicki Minaj's lawyer? Do you think that this is a conflict of interest? And do you think this will change the way the case is going? I look forward to reading your comments. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. I love you guys. To the minute back, and we'll talk down below. Bye, babes.